Sorry about the following video, guys. I don't even know if any of it's gonna be watchable. Everything happened in real time and I filmed it and that was that. Sorry that it's too long or rambled, or I'm not gonna be editing it. Drop some footage in and that's that. I came outside this morning, about 20 minutes ago. Literally still drinking my little coffee. Look at the piranha tank, doing fantastic. I was actually super excited to show you guys something, which all the tanks are now moved off the stand. I can start moving forward with a lot of stuff. Tyrese is here to say hi. Saltwater tank's doing great. The first tank I always check out, though, is the 375, because these are my most sensitive fish out in the gallery. Little baby stingrays. We got a couple pearls, a little black diamond, and then all of these Ultim Angels in the back. They're a little stressed out because I've messing around here, but all doing perfectly fine. A lot of that has to do with the fact that they're on a massive amount of water volume. 375 gallon tank, 180 gallon sump, connected to a 2000 gallon tank. When I first got out here, I noticed a bit of a smell though. Something was stinky. I look in the tank and I saw two dead stingrays. I was like, what just happened? Did this tank crash? What's going on here? I look around the tank, everybody's doing fine, including even more sensitive fish like this panda walru here. The female stingray, in perfect shape, absolutely nothing wrong with her. Everything great in this aquarium. What the heck happened to my two smaller stingrays? Well, we know they were getting into breeding. We knew that, I also kind of moved them to the 2000, back to the 2000, simply so they would have even more space, because I knew the female was getting a little aggressive with everybody, and she's just so much bigger than the others that I was like, okay, you got to go in the 2000. I check water parameters. Obviously, everybody's perfectly fine. They've been in the tank for a few weeks, eating, acting normal, business as usual. I then examine one of the females' bodies, and I noticed that she was, the male got her last night, like he had intercourse with her. And you could tell from her orifices being like open when it shouldn't be. Then I noticed the male is completely ripped apart. The big female's breathing heavy, but the other two are just gone. They're both torn up. I think what might have happened was the female got aggressive. Stingrays, freshwater rays, are personality fish, but they can be pretty ruthless and pretty aggressive, or at least defensive towards their own species and whatnot. If you've ever seen a male and female stingray breeding, the female does not want to do it, but the male forces her, biting at her, ripping at her disc. He'll rip chunks up just to get her to lift off the ground, and then he grabs her, pins her down, or swims around with her, belly to belly, forcing her. It's incredibly violent. So, I'm not surprised by this. I'm just shocked that it happened in one of my aquariums. Again, I thought maybe it could be water quality. Obviously not. Not with those types of fish in there. Everything's kind of checking out. And then I thought maybe it could be diet, or, you know, just because a fish dies and you assume that everything's okay, or you think you know the problem, it's still a good idea to investigate all other aspects to ensure nothing else is going to happen in the aquariums. Obviously, I'm doing a big water change just to dilute the ammonia that the rays started to give off. A scaleless fish begin to rot almost immediately. Within a couple of hours, they'll start developing patches and, well, you've seen the bodies. But the female being bit up and then looking like she was, that the male got her, and the male being absolutely ripped apart. All the other fish in the tank are in absolute perfect shape. Look, she's swimming all over the place. She's fine. But everybody else is like, there's no torn fins. They look like they might be a little stressed out because of the spike in ammonia. All I've done right now is I shut the return pump off. So this water's not pumping into there, but it did all night. And that's the only thing. I'm surprised with those two rays dying
that it didn't wipe out both these tanks, but with this type of water volume, that's simply going to be next to impossible. I've had these raised for about 8 years, so that's a tough one to swallow. I remember the day I got them. She's breathing pretty heavy, but I'm pretty sure she's gonna be fine. She's probably just stressed out. But then I start going through other scenarios. Am I feeding the right diet? Am I feed my do-it-yourself mix, and I give them Northfin Carnivore. It's basically what they've gotten their entire lives. Every fish that I've ever had that will eat it, eats it, it's fine. Can't be diet water quality. There'd be signs of, especially the baby rays or the Altums or the Panda Waru. You guys know that those are incredibly sensitive. They would have been the first to go if it was some sort of water quality spike in ammonia, something like that. Could it have been stress from moving them to the 2000 recently? It wasn't as recent as you think. It was more than 2 weeks ago, and they've been eating daily. In fact, I was coming out here this morning first thing because I was going to do a feeding all my fish video. Defrosted this last night. And then that's when I noticed it. But big fish, big problems. It sucks, but it is what it is, and these things can happen. Oh, man. I think that she might be pregnant, and she got food resource hiding, or what's that called? Resource guarding. I think that maybe the male was just wouldn't leave her alone, and he got her. Other than that, I mean, there's no other explanation. Not for those two to be all completely ripped apart, beat up, and then she's perfectly fine. Yet she's also the one that's like twice their size. I'm left with the question, like, what's next? Do I continue to house this incredibly aggressive stingray? If so, that means no more rays can go in there, and we have three others that eventually are going in there. Or do I hope to find a new home for her and, you know, get a bunch of smaller stingrays for there? Because I know I've got three albino pearls coming at some point. And then I have another black diamond and two other pearls. So maybe I'll just get more black diamonds or something. But they can't go in with her because they're too small. No, she'll rip them apart. You know, I think I'd be more upset if it was my fault. Like, remember when Buddy the Asian Arowana died? And we haven't had, in 7 years that the gallery's been open, and the amount of fish that have come through here, I can count on two hands how many fish have died. We've lost them due to hurricanes, due to heat waves, fish jumping, stuff like that. Never due to like actual negligence. Perhaps I could have, or fighting. We had two Asian Arowana fight before, and one was one lost. There's always something, I guess, that you could possibly have done. But what is the scenario here that I could have done differently? Separate them? They weren't really, there was no signs of like severe aggression. And with so little tanks set up, I don't have many fish to watch. I just stare at my few little tanks that are set up and seeing a lot of the intricacies and noticing more and whatnot. So, yeah, I think right now I'm just in shock. That sucked. That sucks. I will say that I think that I've been incredibly lucky in terms of being in the hobby this long, keeping fish for as long as I have, especially the rays being, 7, 8 years old, the Asian Arowana being 7, 8 years old. I'm surprised that guy hasn't jumped yet, because Asian Arowana love to do that. And to have never had real issues. Obviously, when I upload a video, I don't hide fish. I don't pretend they're here or not there. I did something, and when I didn't, I always like show you everything. And so obviously, these types of videos usually get a lot of views. Any drama type of stuff on YouTube, you guys know. It can be devastating, but at the same time, I gotta tell you something. I thought about uploading my regular video that I was working on, but it's like super happy, and then what? Halfway through, be like, oh yeah, the rays, my female killed everybody. Anyways, you know, that would have been heartless. And they didn't deserve that, but I also didn't want to put in a lot of production into this. I said, grab your camera, Joey, and just show them. You know, I've got the footage, you know, and that'll be that. Well, it's a great start to the week. If I rescape the 2000, we could probably put a ton of substrate in there, plants, that sort of thing. I guess that might be the only good thing that comes of this, but even then, it's like, I'd rather none of this had happened. We can talk about the idea that they've been moved around a lot, and that's gonna, of course, moving fish can be stressful, but the elastomal branch is not necessarily, it moves differently, and you know, when they're moving from 3 feet away in the same water parameters, water quality, water temperature, is literally in the net for 3 seconds. It's not something I'd even entertain the idea of, like, oh, that might be a cause. But of course, there will be people that have never owned a stingray, probably never even seen one in real life before, yet are going to say things like, oh, Joey did this wrong, that wrong, and the other thing. You know what, I'm already thinking everything I could do wrong, but we have to be reasonable. And, you know, was it water quality? Obviously not. Was it tank size? No. Was it diet? Unlikely everybody would have been wiped. The thing that, like, irks me is that the little baby rays and the altums are perfectly fine. The most sensitive fish out here. It doesn't irk me. It's just that's what obviously can't be water quality. Look at the evidence. The female beat up the males. When males breed, if you've ever seen a male stingray breed with a female, it is not consensual. A lot of people love stingrays and call them little water puppies. Wait till you see them breed. It's incredibly violent and brutal on the male's part. I think the male probably bit off more than he could chew. It looks to me like he got the other one and he was going after her and she flipped out. I'm assuming, because I don't have the footage, there's no camera on this tank anymore. But yeah, that's how I started my day, and that sucks. But again, these are things that can happen. Not to my hobby, though. That's what upsets me the most, is because these things I'm in control of. You know, as arrogant as it sounds, I know what I'm doing with fish. But I can't control if they go to war in the middle of the night while I'm sleeping in a 2,000-gallon aquarium where they've gotten along for 8 years prior in all their variety of sizes of tanks, but damn. 8 years. My hobby is going to fundamentally change. Again, I think I'm just in shock. I don't feel sad. I'm just in shock. I'm not embarrassed. There's nothing to be embarrassed about or shy about or anything like that. Just a bit in shock. You know, did I expect for this to happen? No. Is it possible? It's possible for the arowana to jump so high out of the tank, he ends up in the saltwater tank. Does that mean I can't have the saltwater tank within 4 feet, or maybe I should put on steel lids or something? Like, things can happen. Everything can happen. It just sucks when it does. This tank could explode one day. You know, anything could happen. A pipe can burst. Fish can fight. If it was a tank full of tetras, like 100 tetras, and 2 of them were killed, like, nobody would care. But these are bigger animals. And I don't care how anybody feels. They're my fish. They've been with me for 8 years. They're the reason I built the 2000. It sucks. It really sucks. The funny thing is, I scooped them out of the tank as fast as I could. Not to save everybody else. It's like, I was in so much shock that I just scooped them. Got them out, put them in a net, and I put them out in the snow. They're out. I don't know what to do with them. They're just out in the snow. And I have to figure that out next. All right. Well, that's that. I don't know what to do. I don't know what to say. Hobby sucks sometimes. When I started the gallery, I said specifically that and I'm just going to use this as perspective. When we set up that rack of tanks, before a single fish was out here, I said, once we set up all these tanks, we're going to rescape and restock all of them. Everybody loved that idea. I said that live in a live video. I think 250,000 people watched that video. I hear it to this day, like, oh, Joey's switching out fish too much and moving things, blah, blah, blah. That was always the plan. That was the whole reason for the gallery. But the sheer volume of fish that have moved through the gallery versus how many have passed away is less than 10. Sucks, man. What? So if the female's that aggressive, now what? What do we do? They're in a 2,000-gallon tank. How did she get them? I don't know, man. I'm going to, you know, obviously I'm going to be racking my brain all day long about that, but I think I'll just let this settle in. Maybe I'll even have to refilm this, or no, I'm just going to upload it. I don't care. Everybody else is fine. It's obvious what happened. It's obvious what happened, and I think, like I said, I'm just in shock, and I'm trying to come up with a miraculous reason. Like, they're almost still in there. I keep looking over, like I'm supposed to see them swimming around and stuff. What to do with her, I don't know. Can't put the babies in there with her, though. Clearly. Just a nasty, big mama. All right, goodbye.